Back now with a Today Health Alert, and tick bites are this morning being linked to a steep increase in cases of a rare condition causing meat allergy.
To discuss, we're joined by Dr. Nick Coatsworth in Canberra. Doc, good morning to you. Can you explain the health concern here?
Yeah, this is a really interesting one, Carl, but I should say that meat lovers around Australia should not be concerned by this, but it's just a really interesting example of how our immune system works. You know, mammalian meat, except for great apes and humans, has a particular protein sequence that is not in our body. So for a very small number of people around the world, but it is increasing in the United States, you can actually develop a meat allergy. So when you consume meat, you end up with allergic reactions about 3 to 6 hours later. So it's a really interesting issue. And yes, you can get it in Australia, which is, but it requires some sort of expert diagnosis to make.
So if you're saying this is rare, how many Aussies does it affect?
Yeah, so there is an actual number attached to that. Around the world, it's about between 10 per 100,000 and 100 per 100,000. So you can see on those fractions that it's not common, but probably in Australia, something that's more found on the East Coast due to the prevalence of a particular little parasite called a tick.
And they're terrible little things, and then they're ever at the moment seem to be in plague proportions in some parts, worse in the summer, obviously. What do you do when a tick has embedded itself in your skin? Because we used to just get the tweezers out and rip it out, but there are different ways of doing it now.
Yeah, there's different ways of doing it. There's a whole heap of ways that it'll tell you online. But the idea is, as long as you get you do use those tweezers, and as long as you get them around the head and actually move the pincers out, then you get less local reaction and inflammation. It's really important, Carl, not to be too alarmist as well about ticks, because so many of us get bitten by them, and so few of us actually get sick by them. But it's been an area of deep controversy in medicine in Australia. There's been decade-long Senate inquiries into the effect of ticks on our health. So very important to have a look at this, to continue to have a look at this. Very important not to panic if you get a tick bite, and just remove it with those tweezers and keep an eye on it.
Well, what is the greatest risk then to Aussies?
So I think the risk to Aussies basically is you might get a little infection there. That's probably, that's quite a minor ailment. But there are other illnesses called rickettsial diseases, and they can give you fever and land you in hospital. Obviously, not a huge number of people getting those, but I see those in my daily practice. And this meat allergy, you can get it from a tick bite. But again, don't expect your GP or even a physician like me to be able to diagnose it. It's a rare condition, and it requires expert immunological support and diagnosis to get.
So I know that you're like the sitting medical professional on this cross this morning, but Dr. However, Jenny, my mum, when I tried to remove the tick with tweezers, got right up me. She said, you can't treat it like that way anymore if the tick's still embedded in you. You've got to put something on it, like some kind
like
of...
Like alcohol.
Yeah, alcohol or whatever.
Alcohol or ointment or something like that.
And so she's going to get really cranky at me if I don't tell you that you've got this terribly wrong this morning, Doc.
Absolutely wrong. Well, Dr. Jenny, I think there's a number of different ways to do it. Provided that you get the head of that tick out, you'll be okay.
All right.
Good advice.
You don't want to leave it in there, that's for sure. Good on you, Doc. Thank you so much.
Thanks.